Hi, welcome to Genie in a Bottle. Today we have some shrimp and some butter sauce I made. And then I have some noodles right here. I can't see it that much. Trying to make it light the best way I can for y'all so y'all can see it better. Y'all just have to bear with me, my blessed babies. Okay, and I'm going to show you the noodles that we have today. Oh, it's a little hot here. We have these Chinese kind of noodles. They beefy noodles. Probably can see it better from back here, but these are kind of noodles that is. It's, you say it in Chinese, so, but I know it do say right here, instant, it says instant noodles, artificial beef flavor, spicy beef flavor, so. And then this right here come in when it, y'all know I can't take all that heat. And then this come in it. And then some, like, some little vegetables come in it too. So I'm going to start off with prayer. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord Jesus, I just thank you for the food that I'm about to receive in my body. Let it bring nourishment to my body. Lord Jesus, I pray for the ones that are getting ready to eat with me. Lord Jesus, bless them as well. Let it bring nourishment to their body. I pray for those that don't have, Lord Jesus, on this day. I pray that you drop a supernatural for them on this appointed day. In Jesus' name, amen. And I pray for all of my blessed babies. From everybody that's on this YouTube today that's appointed at this time. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay. We're going to dig on in. Whew. So y'all like these noodles? Ooh. I like them, but you see how it is? I'm going to start trying to talk without no food in my mouth. Whew. That's going to be hard for me. These shrimps look so good. So yum, yum, good. Y'all can have the first bite. Ugh. Mmm, that looks so good. Mmm. It's your first bite there. Yum, yum. Got a little bowl to put the other part in. This is good. See these shrimps here? My husband bought me 2 bags of these. For, $9.99. I put a little cayenne pepper so it's going to the back of my throat. Mm. But it tastes good. What I'm going to do, because these noodles need a little bit more juice to me, so I'm going to put some of that butter sauce on in there. Because I want it at least loose like this, you know? Yeah, so it can be that yum, yum good. Mmm. All right, water. Grace bottom. So how everybody doing? I hope all is well, even if it's not. I hope all is well, my blessed baby. I had a good day, a nice long sleep. Got to get ready for tomorrow. Got a doctor's appointment. Got a meeting at the church. This whole week is busy. We got some type of Women's Day thing or tea thing for the women. So look forward to that on Thursday night. I'm going to ask a little topic a little later because I'm really concerned. I just want to ask other people because I like to deal with a lot of young people. Y'all seen Miss B Lovely? Y'all see how nice Miss B Lovely look? She had her little surgery done. And she be eating. Y'all don't get food now. That's why I tell everybody. I'm sitting up there eating all that food. I eat too, but I don't, I watch my calories. You sit there and eat all that food, and you'll be sitting up there with problems, and the persons that's motivating you, they'll have you, you know, that you can't, you know, get around and have all type of afflictions that's going on in your body. Just be careful, people. My blessed baby, just be careful. And everybody want to look like a Barbie doll. But I'm at that age, and I'm comfortable with the way I look right now. But I like to see people look nice. She look really pretty. That's one thing I always wanted, was a little small waist. And you know, if some big people has got small waist though, they're good. But when you got the money, hey, to each his own. Just anything you do, like I said, you just be careful and you consult God about it first. Before you do anything and make any major move. I'll tell you, that's the first lady I started watching down south. Her and her family. And loved it. Came home watching. What's up, my B-lovelies? Such a beautiful family. Husband, I like to see that. That's what I like, the type of stuff I like to see. Togetherness. One helping another. Yeah, I don't see my husband that much. Because see, if I'm going to be honest with you, he be tired. And he like to do it once in a while, but not all the time. But otherwise, he do what he got to do as far as this house. As far as me. Well, let me tell you. This weather here. It's May, and it is raining. Been raining yesterday, raining today, raining. And when it rains like that, it make me sleep. Will it make y'all sleep? Because I know I sleep all the time. Angela Ortiz, hi, if you on. I'd like to give you a shout out. And I enjoy watching you. When you're making your videos, you make very nice videos, and I just want to say shout out to you. God bless you and your family. She be making some good food, y'all. Y'all better go over to Andrew or Ty's. I didn't learn how to put the stuff in the description box, I think. I'm going to see could I do it tonight when I get off of this video. I'm going to see. But we'll see. Some of the simplest things will be right there before y'all. Yep. Well. I know. Excuse me. Some of y'all can use a lot of these. I couldn't even use the whole pack. Okay. I don't know what I seem like I'd be rushing for sometime. Like I got somewhere to go or you got somewhere to go. See that? Tastes actually good with that juice in it. I should get me one of them, order me one of them water bottles what everybody got. A littler one, though. But as much as I drink for it, I could do the big one. I don't know, but I might just go. They got some nice ones that, yeah, I know how I am. I be the one to five and below and got me a little nice one. And that's what I think I'm going to do. I'm going to get it made. Yes, okay. So, we know a lot of young boys. We have our kids. I say they start all the way about from 16, 18. You know, sometimes going to prison. And they catch charges. You know, robbery charges. Well, any type of charge what they get a felony with. But before that child went in there, they worked all the time. They didn't, you know, they worked all the time. They went to school and did what they had to do. They lived their life. Okay, then you have the other child that didn't go to school, but they worked it. But as soon as they went to jail, you see that they're not working, so you ask them, you know, why you're not working? You know, you usually work. And they say, the first excuse, I got a felony. Ain't nobody going to hire me. But it's a lot of places. See, that's a lot of excuses with our young men. They be saying that they have a felony and ain't nobody going to hire them. But that's not no excuse. Like the Bible said, man don't work, a man don't eat. You saw? But that'd be a lot of excuses with people today. But they have all types of places for people with felonies that can get jobs. They have like Walmart, Dunkin' Donuts. They have Price Chopper. A lot of places. Different names of places that, I mean, they can get good jobs, take up trades, welding jobs. That's some kind of scrumptious. Yeah. But they can get a job and stuff, but that's what holds them back, you know, like is their mind have to be transformation in the mind for them to change. Because if their mindset is on them, most of the time they go on something that they heard. Because they ain't never been to prison before, and they hear everybody saying, you can't get a job, you got a felony. Or maybe some jobs said it like that, so I ain't going to say, people didn't say it to them. But, we got to encourage our young men and girls, you know. We got to encourage them that, that you can get a job, you know. And the things that people speak out of their mouth, I tell you all the time, they speak in life to it. But there's these jobs out here, but if they want to use that for excuse and live off of, you know, these young, their girlfriends and stuff, hey, that's not a good thing, because I try to tell my son the right way to go. He have a job, but I had a problem with him, too, like that, with saying a felony. He ain't never have been in trouble. And as a matter of fact, the only time he ever been arrested. And he have a job now. So, I thank God for that. You don't give up on your children, but you have to instill it in their head, no matter what your record looks like, you can get a job. And stuff like that, because our young people really need prayer, because the young people nowadays, they so messed up. They got all this illegal stuff they selling right out the corner stores, and got these kids' minds corrupted. And not even, you don't, you scared, sometimes you're scared of your own child. Do y'all agree? And I heard, excuse me, I heard one of the ladies on here saying how they be so mouthy. Yeah, that's how they do. But I tell you, back in my days, you act like you wanted to open up your mouth a little bit, my mother would have knocked you down on your feet. Mm-hmm. They didn't play that back then. Back then, years ago, family watched out for families. They told your mother if they seen you skipping school, I don't know, they'll help your child get a job. They'll help them. Nowadays, some of the parents, you know, just as messed up. So we have to pray for everybody, especially if you see a family like that, that the child and the mother is both, you know, messed up, you know, and all they ever knew was the street life. So don't be afraid to talk to them, you know. Because these kids need none. These police don't care about, ooh, I'm getting full. These police don't care about giving them a violation or probation or parole and taking them back to jail and stuff like that. When I was young coming up, I'm going to tell you something. How probation was, you had a curfew, and they would come to your house unannounced, and they did drug screening on you. Now, these people don't go come to your house once a month. Well, here, I'll just say like that. And, you don't have a curfew. And, it's like they letting the person just bury themselves, you know, in trouble and stuff like that. Because that's supposed to be some type of guidance for them to, you know, like kind of scare them up a little bit. I better start doing right, because I got to be in the house. These people taking my urine. I got a curfew. If I get a job, I could get off, you know, sooner and stuff like that. But their mindset's not like that. They're messed up. I'm telling you. And what's got it like that is these people at these corner stores, you know, and stuff. The things that they're giving to the children, it's not like things that they gave, you know, when we was growing up, which you would go, some people, you know, did, you know, I'm going to talk all about that, but, you know, did things that was illegal. But now they got the stuff that's taking them right on out. So when you see signs like that, when your kids acting strange and they act really angry, like that and mad and have temper tantrum, that's that synthetic drug. Mm-hmm. Well, that's the time to start praying.